गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, साई राम, हाउ आर यू ऑल? आर यू फाइन? यस. सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू विद आवर वैल्यू एजुकेशन क्लासेस. यस. सो इन द फर्स्ट क्लास वी सॉ व्हाट आर द डिफरेंट प्रेयर्स दैट वी डू, इजंट इट? सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी द लेसन नंबर 2. ओके. सो द लेसन नंबर 2 इज द हॉनेस्ट फार्मर. The honest farmer. Okay? So what is honesty, children? Honesty is nothing but being truthful, not telling lies, and you are going to speak the truth in any difficult circumstance. Yes? That is honesty. Okay? So here we are going to see about a honest farmer. So once there lived a humble farmer who lived in a village. He was working upright in character and honest. His mind never hankered after anything that was unnecessary for his daily living. Okay? So there lived a hard working farmer in a village. Right, children? Now, he used to get up very early in the morning and go to the river bank to have a bath and say his daily prayers. Shouldering his plow, he would go to the field and plow till midday. Because of his hard work, he usually got a good harvest. Thus, he was leading a contented life. Okay? So he was a honest farmer. He lived in a village. Okay? So every day what he used to do is he will go to the river, okay, and take a bath saying his daily prayers. Yes, children? After that, he used to shoulder his plow till midday, and due to his hard work, he always gets a good harvest. And what happened one day? One day, early in the morning, as usual, he went to plow the field. He was going round and round, singing divine songs to enthuse the bulls so that they might not feel the strain of work. Suddenly, he felt some hard substance obstructing his plowshare. He was going round and round singing divine songs to enthuse the bulls so that they might not feel the strain of hard work. Suddenly, he left some hard substance obstructing his plowshare. Okay, he found that some hard substance was observed when he was plowing his field. Okay, so what he did, he unyoked his bulls and dug the spot with a spade and found a pot full of gold coins. The poor farmer was taken by surprise. He took the pot home safely. The find of treasure didn't upset him. He slept soundly at night. He said his usual prayers in the morning, asking Bhagwan to give him strength of mind to be desireless. So what is desireless, children? Desireless is nothing but having no desires. That is, you don't want anything in the world that is made up of money, right? He thought, the land belongs to the king. He is the owner of this gold. So I have to give this pot full of gold to him, he said. So what is this farmer doing? He is asking God in his daily prayers that give him the strength to be desireless. And then he thought that the land belongs to the king. So he is the owner of the gold. And next day morning, he set out to the palace of the king. He was given audience by the king. He placed the pot in front of the king. The king himself was surprised to see a pot full of gold coins. "Do you know the value of gold coins?" asked the king. "Yes, Your Majesty, it may be a few lakhs of rupees," answered the farmer. The king was really impressed by the honesty of the farmer. Now, he asked, "Did you not feel like keeping it as you found it by you?" The farmer replied, "No, Your Majesty, it belongs to you as you are the land owner." The king, without any words, he ordered his minister to reward the farmer with 10 lakhs of rupees. The farmer humbly refused the reward, saying, "I have done my duty to my king and the nation. Use the money for the welfare of the people." He walked away calmly. So what is the moral of the story, children? The moral of the story is, do not trade your dignity and honor. So you should never trade your dignity and honor. In simple words, honesty is the best policy, is the moral here. Okay, so I want you to do all the book back exercises by yourself, and we will move on to the next lesson. So the next lesson is about Rameshwaram. So how many of you have gone to Rameshwaram? Yes. So Rameshwaram is a devotional place, right? So many temples have been situated there, and you can also see the Pamban Bridge, which is situated on the sea. Okay, so it's a bridge which connects the railway line, and it is present in Rameshwaram. Okay, we are going to learn about Rameshwaram in value education, how Rameshwaram had become so famous, and what is the history of this. Okay, so are you ready to learn about Rameshwaram, children? Yes. So let's move on to the lesson number 3, Rameshwaram. Rameshwaram is a small island situated towards the southern tip of our country. Here we find the famous temple of God Rameshwara. Okay, so it is situated in the southern tip of our country. Okay, Rameshwaram is situated in the southern tip of country. We found famous temple of God Rameshwara here. It is a large and a beautiful temple. It has the longest temple corridor in the world. Here, the god is in the form of a linga. So, all of you know what is a linga, right? So, here, this temple is a very famous temple because it has the longest temple corridor in the world. And here, the god is in the form of linga. Sri Rama installed this linga, so the god is called as Rameshwara. Sri Rama became blessed by worshipping this lingam before going on a war against Ravana, as well as while returning from Lanka. Okay, so do you know the history now? Why is this temple called as Rameshwara? Because Sri Rama installed this linga, hence the god was called as Rameshwara. And once Sri Rama came from Lanka and
Before going for a war against Ravana, he was blessed by worshipping this lingam, so that it is called as Rameshwaram. There are many holy triktas in and around the temple. It is said that Shri Krishna also bathed here and earned God's blessing. Okay, so there is another story regarding this Rameshwaram temple. Is Lord Shri Krishna bathed here and earned God's blessing. Setu is another name for Rameshwaram. Setu is another name for Rameshwaram. People go to Rameshwaram on pilgrimage. They bring Ganga Jal from Kasi and bathe God Rameshwara with it. The Ramalinga in Rameshwaram is one of the 12 Jyotirlingams of India. So there are 12 Jyotirlingams in India, and one among them is the Ramalinga in Rameshwaram. People, they go for a holy pilgrimage to Rameshwaram. They bring Ganga Jal from Kasi and bathe Lord Rameshwara with it. So now you understand the connection between Kasi and Rameshwara. Yes, so it is one of the 12 Jyotirlingams of India. So children, I want you to mark all these question and answers and learn it. And there is an activity given here. Okay, so do it and read the lesson once or twice, so for your understanding. Okay, so I hope you will understand this lesson by reading it once. Yes, children. So it's very important that you should learn value education, because education comes secondary and values come first. Do you agree with this point? Yes. So learn your value education as you learn your other subjects also. Thank you, children.